Hello everyone, welcome to EdiTop. So in today's session, we are going to discuss a very important news article of finance that is regarding the bank credit and deposit data that has been released by the Reserve Bank of India recently. So this news article is important for the RBI grade B, but it is also important for the NABARD grade A and the SEBI grade A because it talks about the bank data, okay? And it has been released just before the NABARD grade A examination, that is on 7th September. I hope all of your preparation is going really well, and that's why I am bringing such kind of news articles that can be important for the NABARD grade A for the phase 1. Okay, so this news article is also very important considering the NABARD grade A also, okay, for the NABARD grade A examination also. So now before starting with the session, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel and join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So the Reserve Bank of India has released the quarterly statistics on the deposits and the credits for the SCBs, that is the scheduled commercial banks, for the June 2022. Okay, so the data has been recently released and the direct questions can come from such kind of statistics, that is such kind of data. Okay, so starting with that, the bank credit growth has accelerated to 14.2% in the quarter that ended June 2022. So the quarter from April, May, June, that these are the months that were included in this quarter because the quarter is of 3 months. So that ended in June 2022. So the data has been released regarding this quarter, and in this quarter the bank credit growth has accelerated by 14.2%. If we compare it with the previous year, 2021 first quarter, that was that ended in June 2021, if we compare it with that quarter, then it was 6% in the previous quarter of June 2021, that ended in June 2021. The bank credit growth was only 6%. Now if we compare this 14.2% with the previous quarter, then in the previous quarter the bank credit growth was 10.8%. Okay, so this is the data that how much the bank credit growth has accelerated in India, that in the current, in the recent quarter, then you can tell that it is 14.2% that the bank credit growth has accelerated in the last quarter. So now credit growth has been broad based, that the credit growth has been seen in all the areas, that is all the population groups that are in the rural, semi-urban, urban and the metropolitan areas, all the bank groups, that is the public sector banks and the private sector banks, the foreign banks, the rural banks, the regional rural banks, the small finance bank, and all the regions of the country, let it be the northern, southern, northeastern, central or eastern and western, they recorded double digit annual credit growth in that is the quarter that ended in June 2022. So you can see that in the quarter that ended in June 2022, in that quarter there was the credit growth that was happening, and the credit growth was happening in all of the important sectors that you can see. It was a broad-based credit growth, and that's why it is a very important credit growth that happened in the economy. Okay, and this is the most recent data regarding the credits and the deposits, that's why it become important. Now coming to the aggregate deposit growth, so we have seen regarding the credit, now we will see regarding the deposit growth. So year on year the deposit growth has remained in the range of 9.5 to 10.2% during the last 5 quarters. So the metropolitan branches are the ones that continue to account for over half of the bank deposits that are happening in the country, okay, and their share has increased marginally over the last 1 year. So the metropolitan branches are the ones that have literally half of the bank deposits, or near to the half or more than half of the bank deposits, okay, and they have the share that is continuously growing, that has increased marginally over the last 1 year. So the share of current account and the savings account, that is the demand deposits we can say, okay, they are not the fixed deposits, because from the savings account, from the current account, you can take out the money whenever you want. So these are the demand deposits, that on demand you can take out this money that is deposited in the current account and the savings account. In total deposits has been increasing. So the share of the current account and the savings account deposits has been increasing in the total deposits over the last 3 years. Okay, you can see that it was 42%, then it went up to 43.8%, then it went up to 44.5% in June 2022. in June 2021 and June 2022. So it has been continuously growing if we see the year-on-year data. Okay. So now, as credit growth is outpacing the deposit growth in the recent period, the credit deposit ratio has been on the rise. Okay, so credit deposit ratio is that you take the credit here, you take the deposit here, and the credit deposit ratio is rising. That means the credits are higher in the country than the deposits. Okay, so the credit deposit ratio stood at 73.5% at all India level, as if we compare it with the previous year, that was 70.5% a year ago, and 86.2% for the metropolitan branches of the banks as compared to the 84.3% a year ago. So you can see that the credit is growing faster than the deposits. Okay. So now the additional information. See, we were talking about the months of April 2022. The May 2022 and June 2022. Okay, so if we see that in the previous few months, the repo rate has increased. Even after the increase of the repo rate, the credit is still growing at a very fast rate. Okay, that is in May 2022, in April, the repo rate was 4%. In May 2022, the repo rate increased by 40 basis points. That is, it became 4.40%. Then in June 2022, the repo rate increased by 50 basis point, that it became 4.90%. So you can see that the repo rate is continuously increasing after May, but still there is the credit growth that is happening in the country. Okay, generally in a rate hike scenario, when the repo rate increases, borrowing funds becomes expensive for the banks from RBI. Okay, that is, when the repo rate increases, the banks are taking the loans from the RBI at a higher repo rate, at a higher rate. So it becomes expensive for the banks to take the loans. This leads to a rise in the cost of funds for the customers of the banks also. The customers of the bank will also get the loan at a higher rate. Okay, that reduces the loans taken by the customers. But what is happening? You can see that the credit growth is happening continuously. So it also shows that this rate hike has to continue for the credit growth to lessen, so that the inflation can be in control in the country. Okay, so these are the questions. I hope that you will be easily able to answer these questions. The first question is regarding, as per the data released, credit growth. You have to tell the percentage of the credit growth that happened till the end of the June 2022 in the quarter. Okay, then you have to tell this question that the credit deposit stood at what percentage at all India level as compared to previous year. So these were the people that gave the right answer of the previous session question. It was Invincible Priya, Anaina, Anand, Suhas, Tarun, Rupesh, Amit and Nilesh Suryavanshi. So these were the people that gave the right answer, and the right answer was first, for the first question it was HDFC Bank, because the HDFC Bank has released the vigilante. And the second question, the correct answer was Move Band Rakho, because it is a separate campaign. Okay, it is a separate campaign from the vigilante. The third answer was Kotak Kremit, that was released by the Kotak Bank. Okay, so I hope that today also you will be able to give the right answers of both the question, both the previous questions. So thank you very much, everyone. If you have any query, you can mail us here, or you can contact us in this number. Thank you very much.